Hi there, it's Ina here, and today I want to make a page in my new journal, and I want to use this image of Marlene Dietrich. Now, she was a German-American entertainer quite some time ago. So to start with, I'm adding gesso, and I went ahead and covered both sides, as eventually, well, I will be working on the reverse side as well. And now I'm adding very simple watercolor, first in a magenta tone and then in a golden yellow. And I'm using plenty of water to make it easier to spread. Now, I always liked Marlene Dietrich, and especially my mom did. And I actually used a different image of her in a collage I did over a year ago. And there is a video on it. And in the video, I talk a little bit about her life and so on. So if you're interested, there will be a link below. And I will also put a photo at the very end. So now everything is pretty much colored. And now I'm adding extra water. Even though it's still wet, I want it really wet because I want to use some salt to create some fun texture. Now my salt is very coarse. It has very big pieces. And after a generous amount, this needs to dry naturally. It does not seem to work well when you try to dry it with a hairdryer or so. Now it is dry, and I found the easiest way to remove the salt is using a credit card. But I will be doing this somewhere else because otherwise salt is everywhere. Now the salt is gone and it's nice and smooth. And I hope you can see the nice design it created. Next, I want to preserve this image a bit because I'm a messy worker and I want this image to stay nice and crisp. So I'm giving it a little protection using matte medium. I dilute it a little bit with water. That way it goes on very smooth and doesn't leave any streaks or anything. So that needs to dry and then I will cut it out. Now, because the image is in a sitting position, I will give her something to sit on. And so I use the leftover paper and just my Neo color, and I make a little fuzzy line here so she can sit down. Next, I want to do some stenciling at the bottom half of the page. I use a broken rock stencil and some simple acrylic paints. I chose gray and a berry color. I use a very hard bristle brush to do it, and I don't fill in every inch of the stencil, just a little bit here and there. I also have to move it over a couple of times as it's rather small, but yeah, it works in the end. Combining both colors gave me a nice variety of shades and kind of a pleasant soft purple. So next I'm using my ink pad and another berry color and my piece of fabric here just to go around the edges. It gives it a bit of a warm, fuzzy outline. Now because my main image is in black and white, I will not be adding any more colorful elements. But I picked a different craft paper here, some leftover bits and pieces. One has some vintage advertisement on it. One has script on it. And then there's also one with a diamond. And I ripped them partly horizontally and partly vertically. And that's the way I'm going to glue them down as well. I realize here that my camera angle is not the best. It's kind of a new setup, and I think I need to fiddle with it a little bit to get a little better so you don't have so much of me in the picture. Anyway, I'm using matte medium here to glue everything down. I let the pieces overlap, and with this I'm trying to create a bit of interest and a bit of texture and just to bring a little more depth to the whole page. Yesterday was Thanksgiving here in the States. It's a big holiday here, and if you're celebrating, then I hope you had a really fun time with your family and friends and were able to enjoy each other's company. We did, and it was especially nice because I didn't have to cook. I'm not the really enthusiastic cook. I cooked for too many years, and even though I love everything creative, the kitchen duty is not one of them. So I was glad I could just sit down and enjoy the meal without having to put too much preparations into it. I guess that's one of the privileges you get when your kids have all grown up. All right, back to my page. All the bits and pieces are down, and now I'm adding the image again using matte medium. And now I want to define the edges of these pieces a little bit. And I use a Stabilo oil and activate it with a water tank brush. And it gives it a nice fuzzy edge. And it also covers all the white edges you get when you rip paper. Now I will be taking a few more steps before this page is all done, but each one is a bit tedious, a bit repetitious. I guess when I was working on this, I had a little extra time on my hand and I just felt like it. It's not so much my usual style, but very relaxing. But because I didn't want to bore you, I really sped these parts up quite a lot and I also edited a lot. But I think you get the main idea. Now to shade the main image a little bit, I use a charcoal pencil and a little blending stub. It gives a very soft blend and shade, and it doesn't take away or adds too much to this image. Well, let's see what's next. Okay, after I'm happy with the shading here, I decided to add a very thin line right there where my original fuzzy line was. I felt it needed just a little more stability there. And next I use my white signal pen to just outline her little ruffles and her hat, not too much. I'm not going to do anything else to her face or body or anything. After adding a little highlight to the middle line there, I am using my Sharpie to create a wiggly border all around. There are two lines, maybe a quarter inch apart, and I will fill it in with little half circles. Now for this part, I use a Sharpie as it dries instantly, but then for the little designs, I will use my Posca pens in white and black. And again, that is one of those repetitious parts, and it takes quite a while. But here you can have a quick look what I'm talking about. There's a close-up. So just little half circles coming from both sides, and then I will fill it in with black. So now this border definitely took some time, but as I said earlier, it's quite relaxing and satisfying. So here at this point, I decided to do some embossing. I have an embossing pen with two tips, a fatter one and a real skinny one. And really, embossing is something I've never done before. I think this is the second time I've ever trying it out. And yeah, I'm having fun with it. And I want to see if I can create these kind of homemade designs. And as you could see there, the embossing pen picked up a bit of the Stabilo oil, but it really didn't matter because the powder covered it all up. So I'm doing it a little bit at a time because otherwise I forget where my pen is, as it's not so easily to be seen, and I don't want to cover the whole page with powder. So I'm doing a little bit at a time and I jumped way ahead here, again, not to bore you. And I think I went a little overboard, but oh well. And here I wrote her name, Marlene, and I had my head completely in front, so you missed that. But here you can see it. Now I used the gold embossing powder for the name. Everything else is done in white because those are the only two colors I have so far. But then I thought to add a little more gold. And so I added these triple little dots. And that's what you saw there. And now I'm using again my black Posca to do a little bit of a broken outline just all around the white doodles. Now, I think if I would have had a black embossing powder, I probably would have chosen that. But I think with the little outline here, even the white one kind of stands out from the background. So after all the outlining, which again was a bit tedious, I think the last thing I did was add a little liquid glitter to her hat and her little frills. And then I used my white Posca to emphasize the name a little bit. And that was the last step. So here is a close-up, and I hope you enjoyed watching me put this together. I think I went a little crazy with all the doodles and all the embossing, but I had fun. Come and see me soon again. Bye-bye for now.